Next time there's a big story that breaks, a big political or legal scandal, pay attention to what people say about the reporter or the source who broke the news. Are they trying to discredit the reporter, turn people against the reporter, distract from the allegations? Are they trying to kill the messenger? This weekend, there's a great new movie in theaters with that name, Kill the Messenger. It's about one of these scandals. The year is 1996. The reporter is Gary Webb. And the story he broke, stay with me on this, is about connections between the crack cocaine epidemic of the 1980s and the CIA's aid to rebels in Nicaragua, known as the Contras. He wrote the story for the San Jose Mercury News. It was very complicated, but broadly speaking, it showed how the CIA looked the other way while drugs flowed into the U.S. and profits from those drugs flowed to the rebels in Nicaragua. The CIA eventually admitted to some of this, but by the time that happened, Webb had left the newspaper. I'll tell you why in a minute, but first, let's hear from the man who played Webb in the movie. That's Jeremy Renner. You can imagine that a famous actor like Renner, an Oscar nominee, isn't too fond of journalists. When I spoke with him and the director of the movie, Michael Cuesta, Renner even suggested that we in the media are a bit like vampires. But playing a muckraking journalist on screen has caused him to change his mind.
You know, it's nice to be educated in something that I knew nothing about, and I had actually strong feelings about journalists before. Now I'm a little more empathetic.
Tell me more about that. Strong feelings negatively?
Well, in my industry, yeah. You know, I had sort of, they can be vampiric. If that's even a word, but now I really understand sort of the playing field that journalists have to really play in right now.
A little arrogant too.
Huh?
A little arrogant.
Yeah.
And if they're not on your side, it's not great.
Yeah, exactly.
A little arrogant meaning the journalists are a little arrogant. What do you?
Yeah, mean? But I think it takes that. I mean, it takes a guy like Webb, Jeremy playing that, needed to be sort of a cop on the beat, dogged guy. Like he was like a Doberman, That sort of arrogance or that arrogance, I would maybe more put it more of like a really passion. And a clear belief in when there's something wrong going on, it's my job to be the cop on the beat. It's my job to tell the truth and get it out there. And Gary and Jeremy playing him was that guy, you know. Mm. He was that guy that saw himself that way. And I think we need people like that. God, you know, thank God for people like that. I mean, we need checks and balances. And Webb was that's why he was so respected, because he believed in it so much. And he was willing to fight that unwinnable war that ultimately he did fight.
So about that unwinnable war, what I thought was most interesting about the movie was the way it portrays other news outlets ganging up on Webb, trying harder to poke holes in his story than point a finger at the CIA and hold the agency accountable for wrongdoing. Now, it is true that Webb's story did have some flaws. It did make some foolish assumptions. It would have benefited from more on-the-record sources and more involvement from editors. But Webb was onto something big, something important. Media outlets also went after him personally. Webb later wrote a book about what happened, and he mentions this program, Reliable Sources, as one of the outlets that tried to discredit him. So I asked Cuesta to explain why Webb was taken down.
Why was he taken down? I mean, I think many, many reasons. I mean, one, I think he wrote a very incendiary story going after the CIA and exposing some ugly truths about our government. But also, I think, the newspapers. That the big papers, LA Times, New York Times, the Washington Post, you know, wrote discrediting articles about him. And I believe these new papers didn't report on it properly 10 years earlier, as they should have. So I think, you know, they were scooped. The LA Times, we portray it like that. I mean, the LA Times felt they were scooped. But the Washington Post, I mean, Walter Pincus at the time did, of course, have their White House and also CIA connections. So there was sort of a hotline to him, and we depict that in the movie. But I think it's really about this guy, this small-time guy, as they saw him sort of usurp them. And, the way big media started to work in the 80s, they couldn't have that.
After a while, under pressure, the Mercury News backed away from Webb and his story. And he struggled to find another job in journalism later. Webb was found dead in 2004. His death was ruled a suicide. But now his story is getting attention once again as a cautionary tale for reporters and for readers. To be skeptical of the message, yes, to follow up, to fact check, but also to be on guard against people trying to kill the messenger.